Hey, it's Fran, again, with a video about making the silkscreening jig for the DSKY display project. As you know, last year I got the silkscreens made, which I showed in a vlog in, I guess, October. I also had gotten the special low iron glass cut into DSKY-sized little tablets. That would be used to screen the layers onto. And I'd done all the artwork for creating all the various layers. There's 8 different pieces of art that have to be screened into a dozen separate layers to build up the display. So the next thing that I had to do on my schedule was to make a jig to be able to hold the screens and hold the tiles and register so that I could actually screen all the various layers, which has to be done to a high degree of precision and repeatability. And I'm going to be screening a number of different displays, you know, just to try to get one that works. Well, I have some experience with silk screening small objects because I've been silkscreening petals for decades, and so I know a lot about what it takes to set up a screening jig to be able to do a high resolution silkscreen with enamel onto a small object that you also have to hold in place. And so for the purpose of doing the DSKY display on these glass tiles, it was going to have to be a couple of different things that I was going to have to come up with. One is I was going to have to build a screening jig, which would actually hold the silk screens. And I would also have to build a device to hold the glass tiles in place. This was going to be a challenge in itself because, unlike something like a cast aluminum case, which is die cast and which every one of them is going to be about the same size, and you can make a pretty easy sort of holder to drop something like that into. These tiles, they're glass, but they're hand cut down to size, so each of them would be slightly different in size, and they wouldn't necessarily be completely square, and they wouldn't necessarily be have the completely flat edges. So I decided that the easiest way and the most reliable way that I'd be able to hold these little glass tiles in place would be to use a vacuum hold-down system. And to do that, I decided that I would break it up into a couple different components. The base would be made out of maple, which would be easy to tool in my wood shop and would be compatible with the rest of the silkscreen jig, which I was going to make out of plywood. And on top of that, I would create an element which I would 3D print in a couple of different pieces because the shape was going to be kind of complex and it would have to be airtight and built with a high degree of precision. So 3D printing was easy because I just created these models in AutoCAD for a base section and for a top section, and I would print out these two pieces in my printer and then bond them together with some gel cyanoacrylate glue to create an airtight seal, and this would make a really nice precision device for that would hold the tile against two different edges on the left and on the bottom. So I'd basically just slide the tile into register just kind of to sit on those two flat surfaces, and then using a foot controller I would turn on a vacuum pump and that would evacuate the air out of the whole assembly, and that would just pull down the tile to hold it in place. And the reason I'm going through all this trouble is that silk screening requires that you work rather rapidly. The ink starts to dry into the screen as soon as you press it through, and it gets, you know, once it gets into a thin layer, it begins to dry right away. So you're limited to a couple of seconds really to screen the ink through the mesh and then lift up the screen off of the object, pull the object off, bring another object, put it into the jig, drop the screen again. So, you know, maybe 10 seconds, 15 seconds usually. If you start going longer than that, like 30 seconds a minute between objects, well then the screening ink is beginning to solidify in the mesh of the screen, and you're just going to have to stop, clean out everything, clean the screen, you know, remix your ink, and start all over again. So you've got this window of time. So it was very important that I be able to have a jig where I could drop the glass in, screen it, pull up the screen, pull the glass out, and do this rather rapidly, and be able to do it with a high degree of precision. So rather than having mechanical hold downs or clamps or anything to hold the glass, because like I said, the glass pieces, these tiles, are going to be all kinds of slightly different shapes and slightly different sizing. So this was really, after I thought about it a long time, this was going to be the easiest, most rapid way that I'd be able to screen this kind of object. So the first thing I had to set out to do was actually build the jig to actually hold the silkscreen frames. And I did that by starting out with some 3/4 inch double B plywood, which I have in stock, and cutting out a couple of pieces, one being 18 inches square, which is going to be the base, and then doing a 3x18 inch piece, which was going to be a platform which would actually hold the special hinges, these clamp hinges that are used to actually hold the frames. And these clamp hinges, they're very specialized objects. They're very tight, so when they're not actually in an assembly, they're actually very hard to bend. There's no play in them at all, and they're tightly manufactured because they actually are designed to hold the weight of the screen so that when you flip the screen up, it just stays where you put it. So you actually have to pull against them pretty hard to get them to bend and change position. We got two of them I'm going to have to mount into that upper frame, and then that upper frame is also going to have to be built in such a way that it can be adjusted for height, so that I can adjust the level to get it exactly the right height once I get all of the when I get the vacuum hold down jig made. And so these things have to all come into alignment, so I'm going to have adjustability and build that into the holder that's actually going to hold the silk screens. And then there's going to be the vacuum hold down assembly, which is going to have to be clamped down onto the base of the silk screen jig in such a way that I'm going to be able to move it around, because all the artwork on the screens is in slightly different positions on the different screen frames. So I'm going to have this whole assembly be very adjustable and malleable, so I can change the position of the vacuum hold down for each time that I do a layer, to align it with the specific artwork on the specific frame, which is going to be, these are all done by hand, these screens are done by hand and such, so it's all this variation. So I have to be able to have the ability to set up this jig differently for every single stage of the process, and have all of these different pieces of artwork line up with every tile that I have. So a lot of things to consider. So yeah. So here I'm cutting out the base out of a piece of 1/4 inch maple stock, just with a jigsaw and hand sanding. This will be a really good foundation for the vacuum hold down assembly. I made a template of the screw positions on the 3D printed top piece of the vacuum hold down, and just using a center punch to mark the holes into the maple, and I'm going to drill them through to accept number 632 countersink screws, because I've drilled and tapped the 3D printed piece, and those screws will hold it in place. very nicely. Now flipping it over, on the bottom side I'm going to do some countersinks into the maple so that when I put the screws in that they'll be flush and there'll be nothing protruding out the bottom. I want the bottom to be completely smooth against the silkscreen jig so that can be adjusted very easily. I'm cutting a couple of bolts here that I'm going to use. I usually keep threaded stock that I cut down, but in this case I'm using a bolt because I need the wider end to grind a little detent to accept the set screw from an aluminum control knob, and the two pieces go together pretty snugly, and once I fasten that set screw, that makes a really good hold down. Now I have to drill some large holes in the base piece to allow for a range of adjustment. Using a round rasp file again, just to do some finishing and hand sanding, get it nice and smooth, so that it will be easy to adjust and slide around really smoothly in the jig. Looks really nice. So now I have to drill four holes in the base of the jig so I can put in some nuts. Now, I did force fit some nuts, regular hex nuts, into the other portion of the screen jig, but in this case I'm going to need to put these hold down screws in and out quite often, and rather than having a nut that I could easily pop out the bottom, I'm drilling out some recesses to accept some force-fit flange nuts. Now these you got to drive in pretty hard, and I've set them to recess in below the surface of the plywood, so using a nut driver just to be able to pound them in a little deeper than the plywood surface. It's kind of a handy trick. Nut drivers are very handy for need to pound something in that's a little bit large and flat. Kind of a neat trick. So they're in place. And hold down screws, there you go. Works really well. So now I just gotta put this all together. So I have some T6 aluminum plates that are gonna complete the whole assembly. They're gonna actually provide the surface to actually push down onto the maple base. So I'm just going to drill some holes in there for those hold down screws, and the whole thing will make an assembly that will be very adjustable and very secure. Again, just tapping some for the centers and drilling. A little trick with aluminum is rather than drilling through in one pass, drill about halfway through and flip the plate over and then drill through the back end to finish the hole, and this prevents creating an explosive burr on the bottom end of the plate. Just a nice trick. Alright, so there's the maple base and then the two plates and a hold down screw. And that's how it goes together. Should be nice and easy to move around and smooth. Yep. Works like a charm. So now I'm just going to put a couple of screws lightly in place so I can mark the position of the vacuum hold down chamber, because I'm going to be making a seal with some caulk to create an airtight seal around the two parts so that they can come together. But I need to know exactly where to place the 3D printed part without losing the position for the screws. I'm just using regular latex window caulk, nothing fancy. The reason is that I don't need to glue the pieces together. I just need something soft and pliable that will create a really good airtight seal. And the screws are actually going to do the holding in place. So very careful positioning with those marks that I made. Then just hand tightening the screws. I don't want to make these screws tight, I just want to get them to make contact, because the idea is the caulk is going to dry and create a flexible seal between the two parts that will really work well to make an effective vacuum. And again, just putting the whole thing together. One last test. The assembly, and that works really well. Right. Just a final touch to scoop away the bead and make a nice clean bevel on the outside with the caulk against the plastic, and that's pretty much done. So here's the whole assembly. Put the glass plate in. I don't have the vacuum pump yet, but at this point I would turn on the pump to hold it down. And just loosening up the hold down screws, I'll be able to position the whole assembly to line up with marks that are in the silkscreen. There are four crosshairs on each piece of artwork, and those are used to align each piece of artwork with the actual tile, the actual glass tile. I gotta do that over and over again for each layer. So it's all together after I get the vacuum pump in, ready to print. That's it. I'm Fran. I'll see you real soon. Bye!